Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And welcome to St. John's on this beautiful day that God has blessed us with. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules to come and worship with us. Thank you for those that are online worshiping with us. For those that are visiting, you may have received a bulletin. Don't be confused if the bulletin says April 30th. Today is May 7th, and Anita was on vacation. I got everything done, but the date wasn't changed. So, and it's the fifth Sunday of Easter, not the fourth Sunday of Easter. But everything will be in the bulletin as well as on the screen. So again, thank you for being here on this wonderful, wonderful day of celebration. Did you see when you pulled in the driveway? The blessing box. Don Harris, where are you? Where's Don? He's out of town. I'm sure he's watching online. Don Harris and Eddie Schmidt helped also, I believe. So we have a new blessing box, and we'll get it, you know, with the name on it and stuff. But there's already things in there. So I don't know if we did it or people in the community. And that's what that's for, you know, for people in need to come by and take as you need and give as you are able. So it's wonderful to have that ministry up and running again. One last quick announcement, unless you all have something. Hope everybody will join us for another hour following this hour for Sunday school. We're going to have an interesting discussion. We will have an interesting discussion on the gospel text. I'm going to preach on Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. But he also says, whatever you ask in my name, I'll give it to you. Well, we'll talk about that. And Jesus also said, we'll do greater things than him. So we'll talk about that too in our faith formation. Are there any announcements that need to come forward? If
Choir Wednesday.
Choir Wednesday, 5 o'clock. All right. Well, if there are no other announcements, let us rise and begin our worship with a thanksgiving for baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God whose hand we are given, by whose hand we are given new birth, by whose speaking we are given new life.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are welcomed, restored, and supported as citizens of the new creation. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of life. You are the everlasting wellspring. In mercy and might, you have freed us from death and raised us with Jesus, the firstborn of the dead. In baptismal waters, our old life is washed away, and in them we are born anew. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams. Honor to you for waters that wash us clean, quench our thirst, and nurture both crops and creatures. Praise to you for the life-giving water of baptism, the outpouring of the Spirit of the new creation.
Wash away our sin and all that separates us from you. Empower our witness to your resurrection. Strengthen our resolve in seeking justice for all.
Satisfy the world's needs through this living water. Where drought dries the earth, bring refreshment. Where despair prevails, grant hope. Where chaos reigns, bring peace. We ask this through Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit reigns forever.
Amen. Amen.
Our gathering song, You Are the Way.
Sure.
Maybe that's where we were.
Okay.
But
here we go.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Rejoice, rejoice.
Let us pray. Almighty God, your Son Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Give us grace to love one another, to follow in the way of his commandments, and to share his risen life with all the world. For he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated for the hearing of God's word.
Stephen was one of the seven men chosen by the apostles to serve tables so that the apostles could be free to serve the word. Stephen does more than distribute food, however. For his preaching of God's word, he becomes the first martyr of faith. The first reading is found in Acts chapter 7. Filled with the Holy Spirit, Stephen gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. "Look," he said, "I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they covered their ears and with a loud shout all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. Word of God, word of love.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm will be read responsibly by whole verse. The congregation reads the whole print. Psalm 31. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness.
Incline your ear to me. Make haste to deliver me.
Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe, for you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me.
Take me out of the net that they have secretly set for me, for you are my tower of strength.
Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies. And from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. Christ is the cornerstone of God's saving work and the foundation of our lives. We are God's chosen holy people who continuously celebrate and declare the mercy of God we experience through Jesus Christ. The second reading is found in Peter's first letter. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow into salvation, if indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good. Come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, "See, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious. Whoever believes in him will not be put to shame." To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word, as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. Word of God, word of love.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel reading.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.
says, I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me. Hallelujah. On the night that he is to be arrested, Jesus shares final words with his disciples. As the one through whom God is known, he promises to go before them and act on their behalf. The Holy Gospel today according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. This is the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated and invite the children forward, please. Y'all want to come? No? Okay. Good morning.
Morning.
How are you all? You're tired? What time did you get up this morning? I think I got up like at 4:30 or 5.
I don't know.
I was so excited to be here though, right? So yeah, so sometimes we're tired. Hey, Jesus in today's gospel said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I just have a quick question. Who is Jesus?
The Father.
Jesus is the Father? Because he is, because he just said in that scripture that the Father is in him. So you see Jesus, you see the Father. What do we know about Jesus?
He loves everybody. He loves everybody.
There you go. Jesus' way is to love everybody. And that's a pretty good truth, right? Do you know what truth is?
The truth.
It's the truth. It's like saying, amen. Amen means so be it. It is the truth. The truth that the Father is in Jesus, that the Father is in us, and that God loves us. What is Jesus' way? What is a way?
The way that you like to do something.
The way you like to do something. Yeah. What is Jesus' way, do you think?
Truth and love.
Truth and love. That's what Jesus did, always did. That's what Jesus only did. So, as the Father is in Jesus, God, God is in you and me and everybody else. And Jesus' way is all about
love.
And that's the truth that we are to live in our way, right? Can you remember that? So everywhere we go, if we can always remember that God is with us, God loves us, and he wants everyone to know that God loves everybody. That's Jesus' way, right? Okay, that's right. Gracious God, thank you for your way,
For your way.
For your truth.
For your truth.
And your life.
And your life.
Help us.
Help us.
To love.
To love.
Your truth.
Your truth.
Your way.
Your way.
And your life.
And your life.
In Jesus' name you pray.
In Jesus' name you pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Cool. Thanks, guys. It's really as simple as that. But I have a 12-minute sermon to expand on that a little bit. And then we will spend another hour unpacking the rest of today's gospel, because it is a very important gospel, especially for not our lives, but for our world. Please pray with me. Gracious God, thank you for your word, your way, your truth, and your life. Help us to hear those words of love. Help us to live those words of love. Now may the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your hearing, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer, in whose name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, in today's gospel, in an upper room in Jerusalem where he had instituted the sacrament of Holy Communion, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. With those words, in spite of knowing what was going to happen to him later that day and the next day, Jesus continued to build God's house on earth as it is in heaven. With that statement, and with many, many other words, Jesus helped lay the foundation for our house as Lutheran Christians, which is, we are saved by God's grace and God's grace alone, given to the world by Jesus the Christ. And I know you have heard this before, however, I believe we are to be reminded, not just what Jesus said, also what he did to show us that he was the way, the truth, and the life, to prepare and bring us into the Father's house now as we await God's forever kingdom to come. So, what did Jesus do throughout his life to give us God's unconditional love? As we know, he went to, welcomed, accepted, affirmed all people, whether they were family and friends, women or children, foreigners or strangers, and even all of his enemies. Jesus also healed and fed all people in their bodies and in their mind and in their spirit. He was compassionate and caring for all people. But that compassionate feeling that Jesus had was not, oh, I just feel sorry for them. I care for them so much. It was more like a gut-wrenching desire that everyone knew who he was and what he was doing to bring God's love. And that was one of the main reasons that Jesus wept when Lazarus died. He wept because he had that deep, gut-wrenching compassion and anger against the power of sin that kept his beloved children from hearing, knowing, and living the resurrection life that he was giving to the world. In all he did, Jesus was living his baptism. He was showing the world God's love for all, which was no greater scene than in that upper room when Jesus instituted the sacrament of Holy Communion, then went to his cross the next day to show the world the epitome of God's love. Not retribution or violence, love. As he stayed on the cross, forgave the world and died to show the world just how much God is a God of love for all. Would it be safe to say everything Jesus said and did was all about love? Thank you. Would it be safe to build God's earthly house on love as it is in heaven? Absolutely. Would it be safe to say, many people do not know what I called last week the great secret that the world does not know about Jesus' and God's grace? It is a secret to many people. Why does that secret need to be learned? Why does it need to be told? Well, have you ever heard someone standing behind a little box or a preacher of some kind saying, to live in my house of worship, you better believe in Jesus the way I believe in Jesus, the way we believe in Jesus, or you better do this or you better do that or else? You know, Jesus never, ever said or promoted a you better or else belief. Have you heard someone say, if you just believe enough, if you pray enough, God will give you what you want and the healing that you need for you and or your loved ones? Sorry, Jesus did not promise a prosperity gospel. He promised a cross. And he calls us to pick up our cross and follow him. Jesus knew how difficult life was, and Jesus knew our need to live the way of the cross, the way of love. And we will have that discussion in Sunday school about whatever you pray in my name, I'll give to you. Come in Sunday school. We'll discuss that. And have you heard, you know what Jesus said about your lifestyle? Better change your ways. You better pray the gay away. You better renounce your heritage. And sorry, too bad, so sad if you can't change your nationality or skin color. Jesus never, ever not welcomed people for who he created them to be. Loved and in his image of love. Those and many other you better or else statements are very exclusionary. And they bring what? Division and hate for those who are not like them, leading to violence in body, mind, and spirit. Jesus never, ever promoted division, hate, or violence in any form, in body, mind, or spirit. Jesus always promoted peace, forgiveness, reconciliation, restoration, and again, the cross affirmed his love. Do those you better or else statements bother or worry you? They do me, because I have to deal with the aftermath of those beliefs almost every day. And most recently, last Thursday, when we had a meeting here to come together to do a worship service in our community about an affirmation service for those who have been harmed or kicked out of the church for those you better or else reasons. What I heard and learned most, that they were not welcome at this table. Do you know where some, if not many people, get their divisive and hate-filled beliefs? Do you know? You could say the Bible, because you can prove anything you want in the Bible. But specifically, John 14:6, when Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. I believe people use Jesus' words to promote their way of life and their way of faith for the sole purpose of greed and to have power and control over people. And sadly, it has worked for centuries. Luther dealt with it. Jesus dealt with it. And we still deal with it today. What happens when all people hear is they are not good enough for others or God or even themselves? Don't they become sad, lonely, secluded? Don't they feel that there is not a place for them in that house, turned off by that God, and cannot hear or do not want to hear about a God of love? Because they don't want to be burned again? So feeling there is no house, nowhere else for them to go, they retaliate, right? Either against their oppressors and or themselves, causing nothing but more pain and suffering for everyone. You know, no one has all the answers about God, faith, or life. I sure don't. Absolutely don't. God very well could be a vengeful, you better or else God. I hope not. What we believe and what we offer is a different way of life, a different way of faith. There is a better house for people to live in. That house was the house Jesus was building with his words and with his actions of love throughout his life. That house he promised to bring was prepared and given and shed for the world for all people with the precious body and blood of God's love. Last week I preached on the secret of God's grace that cannot be a secret anymore. We are to learn that secret and partner with God to tell that secret, to build God's house on the way, truth, and life. What is Jesus' way? I don't think we can do any better than what the kids told us. Jesus' way to live a life, humble life of service, to feed, heal, love, forgive, restore, and to accept all people. What is Jesus' truth? God's unconditional way of love. What is Jesus' life? A life of love and peace for all people. The truth of God's way. During the 973 days of our rebuild, we often said and learned and are still learning, the church is not about a building. The church is all about what God is doing in, with, and through the people to live and share God's all-affirming and all-welcoming love. That is the house God is building here at St. John's, which is preparing us for our heavenly home Jesus built with his precious body and blood. Our calling as disciples of Jesus Christ is to learn and then live to tell the secret of God's amazing gift of grace. We are telling that gift with our many words right here from this pulpit, in our liturgy, in the wonderful song selections. We are learning and telling that gift in Sunday school and in our many faith formation classes throughout the week. We are telling God's gift with all we do through our many compassion ministries. And I'm so proud of that blessing box. It's already got stuff in there from our community. We are telling people God's gift with what we do, meeting people where they are as Jesus always did to supply many of their needs in body, mind, and spirit. Just as the world has always tried to build its house on fear, God has always built God's house on love. Our vision statement at St. John's is a family of Christian believers called by God to serve in love. Our mission is to be empowered by God to live our vision. Following Jesus' command and his great commission, we are to go to and invite all people to come here, to hear and learn and live to share Jesus' way, his truth, and his life of love to bring more peace and more hope into all of our lives. We believe that is God's vision and mission for the Church of Jesus Christ, for the sake of the world that God so loves. How will we continue to build on the foundations of God's love, to prepare his house to be a house of peace, a house of love, and a house of hope for all? How will we build on God's foundation by giving our time to learn the secret of the gift of God's love? How will we give our talents to live and share God's love? And how will we give our needed treasures to build God's house of love? A house where all are welcome and
all means all.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you.
let us profess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us share God's peace with one another. Sharing the peace when that is, please be seated for our morning offering. Thank you.
us pray. Generous God, in this meal you offer your very self. We give thanks for these gifts of the earth. In the breaking of this bread, reveal to us the risen one. In the pouring of this wine, pour us out in service to the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You may be seated. The prayers of the people. God of life, strengthen your church to proclaim your gospel even in times of trouble. As we remember Stephen, we give thanks for diaconal ministry. Bless all deacons and strengthen them for their bridge-building ministry between church and world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creating God, you show your steadfast love through mighty waters, towering mountains, verdant fields, and arid deserts. Protect the earth's diverse habitats from the forces of pollution, erosion, extinction, and global warming. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Mighty God, your Spirit guides us into all truth. Give wisdom to world and local leaders and organizations as they begin, build, or renew relationships. Strengthen leaders and aid organizations in areas needing to be rebuilt following conflict, unrest, or natural disaster. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Loving God, you make your home among us. Abide with refugees, those experiencing homelessness, those fleeing war and poverty, and all who question if there is a home in your heart. We pray for all who are sick, especially all those on our prayer sheet, and all those we lift up to you now with our voices or in our hearts.
We continue to pray for Rita Brady after her cancer surgery this past week. We continue to pray for Donna Magner as she continues to be in ICU.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Assuring God, you accompany your people amid uncertainty and change. Uphold people in this community who have recently moved, changed jobs or schools, retired, or are going through transitions of any kind. Lead us in your ways. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, we just continue to pray for your world. Yet another mass shooting in Texas the other day. Just be with the victims, all the victims. Lord, help us to be your church that you call us to be, to live the truth, the way, and the life of love, to bring more love, but also to help us when we go through the difficult times.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Renewing God, you gather the saints at your heavenly banquet. We give you thanks for the care shown by those who have gone before us. Grant confidence and comfort for all awaiting the place you have prepared. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Please rise as you are able.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and at all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life.
and so with Mary Magdalene and Peter, and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Now may we be bold to pray and even more bold to live Jesus' prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
You may be seated. Christ invites us to this table. Come and eat and be satisfied, and all are welcome.
And all.
For those online, this is the body and blood of Christ, God's love given and shed for you. We're going to do communion by intinction, as we always do, but we're just going to line up in two stations here, kind of like on Easter or something, just come down this aisle and then commune and then go back to your seats. Okay, and for those that are visiting, the intinction means, it's one of those churchy words. Once you get the bread, or if you want a wafer instead, the gold chalice has wine, the clay chalice has grape juice to dip it into. Come, the table is prepared, and again, all are welcome.
That means all. Come.
Body of Christ, God's love.
Please rise as you are able. The body and blood of God's love, given and shed for you, strengthens you and keeps you in God's grace this day and always.
Amen. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all people. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The God of all, who raised Jesus from the dead, bless you by the power of the Holy Spirit to live in Jesus' way, his truth, and his life.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
$1,000 plus investment. Yeah, that much of a bank. You know, and then.